before. After. What's up? What's going on, YouTube? Second Chance Garage. This is our year in review. You saw the before, this is our after now, and we've grown. Well, at least we got more product.
Got more product. There's definitely more bikes in the building, for sure.
Absolutely.
We started the year off. We were in Kurt's garage, Kurt's little shed.
The one car shed building.
And now we're here. Don't want to say thanks to y'all, but we don't make no money off YouTube yet. But hey, glad y'all are here. Really glad we are at 202 now. 202 subscribers. We started this year off. Let's see, December of 21, we were at 98 subscribers. 98. And now we're at 202. So thank y'all. Thank all y'all.
You want to start telling us about some of the bikes, and I'll talk about some of them?
Yeah. I'm going to start off with the Electric Light here. This is a customer's bike. It's 1977. Electric Light, show head, 1200cc. Came in, the wiring was jacked. So, rewired the entire bike. The only factory wires on that bike are the wire going to the starter and the solenoids. That's it. The rest is all brand new wiring. Handlebars, lights, tail lights, everything in there is brand new wiring. New upgraded system. We've got electronic ignition on there now. Then we had to move to the brakes. Rebuilt the both master cylinders twice. Front brakes are working great. Rear brake. Rebuilt that caliper. It's dragging. So I need to pull that apart and check the piston on that. Make sure it's the same length as the old piston.
Other than that, it's running great.
Oh, it runs great.
Yeah, it's just find a little assembly on that one.
Yeah, it's a little bit rich, but run a little bit rich.
Yeah.
But it's about to go out. See, today is December 31st. It's going to go out Monday evening. It's out the door. All right, Curtis, you want to go next?
Nope. Just go down yours out here. Get those two.
Hang on one sec.
Those two over there.
All right, so these two Hondas?
Those two Hondas.
Alright. This is Curtis's nemesis. He hates this bike with passion. Yeah. Why? I love it.
I think it hates me. I don't know.
It's the 1993 CBR 1000F Hurricane. This bike was a lot of pain.
That's why I don't like it.
It's the Hurricane. Came in, motor was locked up. We let it soak for
2 weeks almost, week and a half.
And some Marvin Mister oil. Got in like 1 a.m. one night from picking up another bike, the CB175 we're going to talk about, and decided to hit the switch, and it gave us a shower of Marvin Mister oil.
Yes,
his shop
literally.
His backyard still smells like
it. Still smells like Marvin Mister oil.
Still awesome. Rebuilt the carburetors on this a few times. Did a basic rebuild, and then found out all the gaskets on the gas lines between each carburetor, they were all leaking. So, tore all the carburetors apart again, rebuilt them again. This bike's running great now. Had to rebuild put new bearings in the front wheel again. Last set of bearings I put in there lasted like 40 miles. I can't remember where I got those. It wasn't Amazon.
They weren't right, whatever.
They weren't right. So, new bearings on that. I had actually had to press them in. They're tight fit. They're good to go. The bike is good to go. It's for sale. Hit us up. The Blue Honda Shadow 2005 model?
Yes.
Yes. When we got this, wasn't running right. Customer didn't know why. We figured out why. The carburetor on the rear cylinder was not connected to the neck anymore.
Yeah. Fuel pump wasn't working.
Fuel pump.
Plugs were like a couple turns out.
Yeah, they were really.
Couple of one of the vacuum lines wasn't hooked up. Mm-hmm. Just a bunch of little bitty stuff.
Yeah. Now we repainted it black. Didn't like it. Painted it back to a very very nice blue color.
Blue. Got the custom lights on it.
Yeah, we did custom lights on that too.
See if we can get a good shot of the metallic. I don't know. It's pretty dusty in here at the moment.
Yeah.
There we go. You can kind of get it.
New front tire on that, custom lights. Previous owner cut the seat, Curtis recut it, and
recut it, made it where it actually better. They had all the extra fabric just bunched up, and so actually got it laid down and stapled in right and cut down.
Factory seat was a one piece, you know, come back to about right here. So we had to get a new seat for it. That's actually off of a Suzuki Marauder. It works, but it starts up and runs great. We had a new exhaust put on. Basically just exhaust pipe welded onto the factory front pieces there.
Sounds killer good.
Sounds good. I got it started.
Start it up. Start it up.
It's going to be a short video, I thought.
It's going to be a long video.
How's that for a cold start?
Such a good sounding bike.
That choke was on. So.
The XL70.
The scooter! No, no. This one.
No. This is what sat outside Nate's house for half the year.
I've had that for like 3 years now.
Yeah.
It's a Chinese 50cc. It's junk. So,
XL70 that we built a while back. It is out of commission at the moment. It has zero compression. We think the rings finally went on it, but it's going to get an upgrade in the next probably month or two for a 125. So this big boy can ride the mini bike again around town and make everybody laugh, because that's what this bike does.
That's all it does.
That's all it does. Around town, it makes everybody laugh. Imagine my big fat butt on it. So it'll stay around. It's not going anywhere. We've debated whether to sell it or keep it, and it's too much fun. It's got to stay. Mm-hmm. So, my Roadstar, which is what I rode all summer. If y'all saw some of the video, I don't know if we did a full video on it. It's set for 10 years? Yeah, because I had 2010 tag on it.
Yeah.
So, 10 years. So, we had to get it carburetor put back on and get it running. And that tank has just been crap. So, it clogged full fuel filters and all kinds of stuff. It had pinhole leaks in it, so we've had to seal that tank. It's been completely sealed inside and out, new paint. There still is a couple little bubbles on it, but it's an 8 out of 10. It's a good 20 footer, you know. But I put 2,000 or 3,000 miles on it, so it runs great. New back tire. We put the eBay special hard bags on it with some mounts for those. Because this one came with the very deep, messed up leather saddlebags.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually think this bike looks a whole lot better with the hard bags on.
Yeah.
So.
If you want the leather bags, it's for sale, by the way. If you want the leather bags, you can have them. Well, still got them?
I still got them.
Okay.
They won't even latch shut. They're so dried. But yeah, they're still in the garage at the house. But yeah, it's for sale. The BMW. We got it refreshed. Nate does not like the riding of this bike. I love the riding of this bike. It rides. It's very smooth on the highway.
That's very smooth. It's just ugly.
You have to get used to that parallel twin of the boxer motor.
Yeah.
And so Nate is not used to that.
Riding position just doesn't fit me at all.
But it's ready. New battery. Brand new tire. Thanks to me putting a screw through the other rear tire.
Yeah. Look at that thing wobble.
She shakes it.
Yep, 99,200 something miles.
Yep, 99,279.
Yep.
Still runs great.
Runs awesome.
Got a nice Corbin heated seat.
Yeah, the heated seat I do like. That's awesome.
And the Corbin Beetle bag.
The Vespa bags.
They look like a Vespa.
Yep.
But I like it. The Purple Shadow. 750, it's 06. Right?
Yeah, 06.
Yep.
And the color is actually Honda's like crimson black cherry or something like that.
Yeah, it's a pretty color.
Yeah, it is.
Got the full-on beach bars on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's got the carb redone. It's got the petcock redone. The petcock still, we think, has a little vacuum. So this is a bike you have to shut off the fuel, or it likes to keep fueling, even with the bike off. Other than that, it runs perfect down the highway.
Yeah, it is. Comfortable, too.
It's comfortable, yeah. So other than the quirk of you got to be aware not being an idiot and shut your fuel off, you're fine.
Yeah. So, all stock.
All stock. Nothing other than cleaning up. Said carb, battery, petcock. That's it. So the only thing wrong is you got to make sure you shut the petcock off when you shut the bike off.
Yep.
So what else out here?
Mad Max.
Mad Max.
Mad Maxim.
The Mad Maxim up there in parts.
Yeah, it's in parts.
So the tank's down here. This is the current project. If you didn't see our video of cutting it in half, it's hilarious. Cutting the rear off.
Mm-hmm.
We got the plates welded in the back. Got them cleaned up. Single seat. We got the custom covers made, which they're just not all the way tight. They won't be rattly when it's tightened down, but Dimple dyed them up with our new little tool over here.
Yeah, our jewelry-making tool.
So
we pulled the tackle box off, and it's just hanging by wires right now because I got to run all the wires and figure out what's what because it doesn't start with these two plugs unplugged.
Well, it doesn't have any lights with those two plugs unplugged. It'll start without them.
Okay. Lights.
No lights without that one. So we got to figure out lights. We're thinking of running a little small GPS speedo. I don't need all that.
No.
So, goal with this is we are going to do a little tune-up with shims.
Yep, we got the valve cover off already.
Yeah, it's, you know, down there. And so we're going to get it all tuned up. It's going to probably be black, British Racing, greenish kind of color.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of faux patinaed, glossy, shiny, dirt tires.
Yep.
Enduro tires.
Our lighting sucks in here.
So.
All that tread.
All that tread.
All
that tread be there.
Yep. We got dose of those.
Yep.
Dose tie rays.
Dose tie rays. And it does have fenders that are in the paint room in the dark.
Yep.
So. Last one out here. We'll switch to you again.
Back to me?
Two out here.
Got two out here? Oh, which one? Oh, the chopper, green chopper.
Up there. I'll let Nate talk on it.
I'm not going up there, but you can look at it.
Yeah, we'll make Nate climb the ladder.
Yeah, Curtis found that frame and tank for like $250. A great deal on that. We're thinking the motor mounts are set up for a Triumph. So we're gonna go back to the Triumph motor on that if we can find one. Then we found a killer deal on that 36-inch long?
36-inch, yep, from the bottom of the headstock to the axle.
Yeah. Springer front end. Killer deal on that. It's like an $850 front end, I think.
Yeah. Paid like $350 for it.
Yeah. Yeah. Sportster front rear tires on there for now, just for looks.
We had them laying around. We put them up there just to see what it looked like. So that's going to be a fun project. That's a slow project as we gather parts here and there as things go by.
Yeah. Back here we've got my newly acquired Sportster, 95 or 97 model. I can't remember which.
It's called a 96.
A 96? It's right in the middle?
Sure.
I got to look. Hang on, editor.
Man, it's dark back here.
It is dark. Ooh. Back here. 95 Sportster 1200. This is my newly acquired bike. I will be probably starting on that in the next couple months, or maybe next year, depending on. It's got to stay rideable when riding season gets here. So
yeah, it can't get too crazy because he's got to ride it this year.
Yeah, it will be getting off-road or enduro tires. It's going to be a scrambler style build.
Yeah.
But that's all I need to know for now.
Well, and then the one back here we didn't put on the list to talk about, but...
The Marauder.
So, the one that's going to be pearl white and hard-tailed, and so we'll kind of just glaze over that one.
Yeah.
Let me go back here. Room. Very dark room. So let's go. Where are we?
Can you find it? There you go.
Let there be light. And I'll let Nate continue talking.
All right, we've got my KZ550. Got a pretty decent deal on that. But the issue with that right now is the starter clutch is out on it.
Yeah.
And the starter clutch on that,
you gotta turn the bike over.
No, you gotta pull the motor out and do everything but split the motor apart.
You gotta turn it upside down, basically, yeah.
So that's gonna be probably an over the summer project on that.
Yeah.
That's not gonna be anytime soon, but as you see, it's already been hardtailed. These bars are coming off of it. I'm putting the ape hangers back on.
Big apes that are hanging. They were hanging down there. Oh yeah, they're sitting on the shelf. The big apes. Those. Going back on it.
They will go back on there. And it's also probably going to get dirt tires. Nothing bobbers with dirt tires just look good.
The bobber with dirt tires, yeah.
Yeah.
All right,
back here we've got our 1959 Harley Sportster. The iron head, 1200 heads on it?
It's a 900.
Oh, it's a 900?
Yeah. It's a 900. It's a 59 bottom end with 57 heads, which are the first year of the iron head. The serial frame puts it 63 to 65 on the frame, but it's been a hard-tailed frame, of course, with the old Springer front end. So it's kind of a mishmash of parts, but technically VIN numbered, titled, it's a 59. Because that's what the case is. So, and we're going to put it back to how it was built in its glory days, just cleaned up. So I don't think we'll be doing full re-chroming or nothing, but it'll look like it's set in a barn for a while, but run 100%.
It's going to be a dirty build.
Yeah.
Very dirty build.
So let Nick take the camera and we'll switch to that one. My 07 Sportster, which is stripped down because it's waiting on paint. It's got a whole box of parts over there for new pegs, new bars, new controls, new lights. I just got to do the paint first so that we can put everything together.
Yeah.
So it's sadly been put on the back burner as we've worked on other projects because I want the paint to be
perfect. As perfect as Second Chance Garage can get it.
Yeah, perfect as I can get it. Cafe Mike.
You know this one.
212, the first one we did on the channel. The KZ frame, the 2-steel Pritiker motor. And yes, it's still around. It's not going to go anywhere. It's too much fun.
Yeah.
So, it gets to hang out at the shop at the moment. May go back hang out at my house this summer again.
Washed out by the light there.
Washed out by the light.
Yeah.
All right, okay. Let Nate talk on that one.
No, you should talk on that one. That's your favorite. It's defect.
It's defect.
That was our 8-hour rat bike build. We did a little live stream on that. The 8 hours, and we put how many bikes we got in that thing?
So the XL70 tank, the motors off a mini bike, then we have the seats made out of a jacket sleeve that was mine from the shop. we got the lights off of. Remember where we got those lights? We had them ordered for something and put them on, but didn't put them on. So Amazon. But yeah, it has multiple parts off of different things. Carburetor.
The handlebars are from a four wheeler we got to sell
yeah,
the yard.
Yeah, those are four wheeler bars.
That grip right there came off of the CB175.
Yeah, it's actually a bicycle grip.
Yeah.
Came off the 175.
The only new part this thing has is the clutch cable.
Yeah. The clutch cable and the little orange shifter knob I jammed on there just for.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right.
So.
Let's see here.
And for a leaky little thing, it runs all right.
Oh, I think the muffler right there came off the CB175 also.
It did.
Yes.
So, it was whatever parts we could dig up. And what's bad is, it was, I don't know, 40 degrees in here the other day, and I threw the choke on and it started the second kick.
You are like an angel right now, Curtis. You got the halo around you and everything. Talk about the 175 now, the CB175. It is no longer here because we traded it for that 59 Ironhead hardtail. That 59 was sitting in a guy's front living room. It was like a clothes rack at the time. The Honda CB175 Cafe Racer, I bought it on Thanksgiving of last year. I was over in Arkansas for a family get-together, and I went motorcycle shopping. So the next week, me and Curtis went and brought that thing back from Arkansas. Changed the bars on it to some Clubman-style bars. Rebuilt the carburetors on that. Had new exhaust put on that also.
Put a custom fender on there because it didn't have fenders.
Yeah, didn't have a fender on there, so we fabbed up a new, well, cut up an old fender off of something else. I don't know what it came off of, but it looks good. New bar end lights, signal lights, you know. New tail light, because the tail light that was on there was an LED strip that was glued to the seat. The seat was the worst looking part on that bike, and the seat looked great. It just had a glue strip on the
glue
back
residue
of it.
Residue still, yeah.
Yeah, but the kid of the guy that we traded it to is riding that thing around like crazy. He loves it. He's got pulled over because he ain't got a license. Yeah, but he loves it. He rides around town all the time. Still no license, I don't think.
I don't think so. Yep, we still see it occasionally.
Yeah. Kid, if you're watching this, go to Myers Duren, get your license.
Yeah. We've had a couple others through, a couple of Shadows worked through. The Sportster that we did buy, and front control. So we've had some others through here that were customer stuff. Mm-hmm. But right now, that's where we're at. Going to try to get the Maxim done so I have something to ride this summer. The Roadstar, the BMW, both Shadows.
We stopped recording.
So, the Roadstar, the BMW, both Shadows, and the CBR are for sale. So,
Roadstar, BMW, Shadow Maroon, Shadow Blue, CBR.
Yeah.
All for sale.
I get some money for the shop revenue, so yep. Selling all the fun ones. Consider I rode the Roadstar, the BMW some this summer. Those were mine riding. Nate rode the Blue Shadow. He's kind of sad to see it go.
Yeah. Oh, blue motorcycles.
Goldwing.
My Goldwing. You will see that back on the channel soon. I've got to rebuild the head replace the head gaskets on that. That is actually going to become property of Second Chance Garage because I'm taking the Sportster over there. So you're going to see the Goldwing back in the shop very soon.
Yeah, and we have a Boulevard coming because we traded the Victory sitting back there for a Boulevard.
So oh, yeah, Victory.
We didn't talk on it. So.
No, we didn't talk on that. It needs third gear, but yeah, we're trading it.
Yeah. So somebody wants it and trading a Boulevard that needs a little bit of work. So
yeah,
it's not like we don't have another 800cc Suzuki sitting around, so.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I'll be glad to work on the Boulevard. You'll see more of it because it'll probably be the next bike to get running to sell.
Yeah.
Because it won't be the custom. The customs, Maxim, Marauder in the back room.
Back there you can't see.
The Sportsters, all the Sportsters.
Yeah, all the Sportsters.
All the Sportsters, and then the Chopper.
Chopper!
So, we got enough custom fun things of our own to deal with before taking on another one, so.
Yep. Anyways, we got stuff for sale. Hit us up. Preferably, if you want to come test ride a motorcycle, hit us up on Facebook Messenger. We're on Facebook. Second Chance Garage. You know the logo, the 2C in the circle.
Mm-hmm. We're on all the social stuff.
Yeah, he's on TikTok with us. I hate TikTok. He's got TikTok down. We're on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. We would have a MySpace if I still know how to get on MySpace.
Is MySpace still alive?
Yeah, MySpace is still alive. It's not like it used to be.
Not like it used to be.
No. So, anyways, this is going to be going up at 11:59 p.m. tonight. It's December 31st, so we get it in this year.
End of this year.
Yep.
See y'all next year.
Yep. See y'all next year. Next week, probably, I hope. Happy New Year. Peace.
Later.